Hello and welcome to the In Focus series section of Drishti IAS. I'm Aisha, and in today's episode we will be discussing about the topic of stubble burning and how the process of stubble burning is violating a person's individual right, that is Article 21, right to life, and especially right to life in an pollution free environment, or you can say in a safe living environment. So as of now, on daily basis we are seeing that the air quality in the national capital, that is Delhi, is deteriorating at a very rapid pace. Now what happens during the season, where the season is changing and the winters are coming and it is Deepavali time. So the first of all, it is winter, so the winds are not blowing at a faster pace. The withdrawal of monsoon has taken place. Stubble burning is on a rise. Construction activities are taking place. Firecrackers are taking place. Then vehicular pollution is there, and above all, winds are not blowing, rain is not taking place. So cumulatively, all this leads to higher pollution levels in the national capital, and as of now the air quality in the national capital is at a very poor, the AQI is very poor. So let us see what is it, the points of discussion. First we'll be looking at the news, then right to environment, stubble burning, what will be its impact or the impact of stubble burning, and in the end prelims MCQ. Topic is of relevance from general studies paper 2, that is polity, and you can say acts or fundamental rights. So the news talks about stubble burning violates right to live in a pollution free environment, Supreme Court. So stubble burning, right to live in a pollution free environment. Now right to live in a pollution free environment comes under Article 21, right to life. So Article 21, right to life, has many sub points under it, and one of the points is right to live in a pollution free environment. Now let's see forward. So the Supreme Court has recently said is that continuing cases of stubble burning and the pick and choose policy adopted by the Punjab and Haryana government. So the Punjab and Haryana government is doing that, they are picking some of the people who are doing stubble burning and penalizing those people, while the others are not dealt with properly. So the pick and choose policy is being criticized because some people are getting punished for it, while some people are not getting punished for it. Now stubble burning is a major practice which actually happens in the surrounding areas of, you can say, the national capital. You can say Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Punjab. So these are the states which do a lot of stubble burning at this point of time, during the time of Deepavali, or also you can say that during the time of October end or November. Now when the stubble burning takes place, the pollution level rises to a very high extent, and Delhi, because it is locked from everywhere by other cities or other states, finds itself in a gas chamber type situation, where the air pollution reaches so high that people tend to start having major breathing issues, and also the air that they are breathing, the AQI, that is the air quality index, reaches the very poor category, which becomes difficult for the people to breathe, and the senior citizens or the animals they are the worst recipient of it, because the people who are having severe respiratory problems like asthma, the situation becomes even worse for them. So there is a fundamental right vested in every citizen in India under Article 21 of the Constitution to live in an environment free of pollution. This is what the Supreme Court has said, that in India, Article 21 gives right to every individual to live in an environment free of pollution. And if people are not able to live in an environment free of pollution, it means that their fundamental right is getting violated. Now let us talk about the right to environment in Indian Constitution. So right to environment, in how many different phases it has been dealt in the Indian Constitution. So first of all, right to life under Article 21. So in the Subhash Kumar versus State of Bihar 1991, it held that Article 21 includes right to wholesome environment. Now right to wholesome environment comes under right to life in under Article 21. Now next, coming to the directive principles of state policy. So Article 48A, it talks about to protect and improve the environment and further to safeguard the forest and wildlife. Improve the environment. So it is a DPSP. DPSP is, that is directive principles of state policies, are goals that state need to look टू मेक थिंग्स बेटर फॉर इट्स सिटीजंस. सो नेक्स्ट इज शेर सिंह वर्सेज स्टेट ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश 2014. अंडर दिस द नेशनल ग्रीन ट्राइब्यूनल हेल्ड दैट द स्टेट इज अंडर अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल ऑब्लिगेशन टू प्रोटेक्ट एंड इम्प्रूव द एनवायरमेंट. सो प्रोटेक्शन एंड इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑफ द एनवायरमेंट इज वॉट द स्टेट इज अंडर ऑब्लिगेशन. देन कम्स एमसी मेहता वर्सेज यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया 2002. इट टॉक्स अबाउट दैट द कोर्ट हेल्ड दैट आर्टिकल 39 क्लॉज ई, आर्टिकल 47 एंड आर्टिकल 48A, दे कलेक्टिवली कास्ट अ ड्यूटी ऑन स्टेट टू सिक्योर पब्लिक हेल्थ एंड एनवायरमेंट प्रोटेक्शन. नाउ एनवायरमेंट प्रोटेक्शन इज ऑल्सो अ ड्यूटी ऑफ द स्टेट. सो दिस वॉज अ फंडामेंटल राइट. देन कम्स द डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ स्टेट पॉलिसी. देन कम्स द फंडामेंटल ड्यूटी. फंडामेंटल ड्यूटी रेस्ट ऑन द सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया. सो आर्टिकल 51A clause, you can say sub clause G, talks about, it puts a fundamental duty on the citizens to protect and preserve the environment. It means that the person also need to protect and preserve their environment, because it is also the duty of the citizen towards the environment. Then what is stubble burning? So rice and wheat straws. So rice and wheat straws, when they are harvested, rice and wheat straws left in the field after combine harvesting, they are generally burnt by the farmers. So when they are burnt by the farmer to prepare seed bed preparation and seeding. So when they are burnt by the farmers, they cause a lot of pollution in the environment. So farmers find this method quick and cheap as compared to other practices of crop residue management, because crop residue management becomes expensive for them while stubble burning becomes easy for them. Then since input costs of farming is going up day by day, farmers are not willing to further invest in equipments which are useful for crop residue management. So they prefer burning that residue or that wheat or rice straws, which ultimately lead to the increase of pollution in the environment. Now what are its impact of stubble burning? First of all, environmental pollution. So agriculture fires are a major contributor to air pollution in North India during the time of October, November. Then pollutants from these fires are spread across the region and they trigger smog and extreme air quality situations, and this make the situation even more severe for the people. Then harmful to the health of the soil also. Now burning of crop residue removes huge amount of nutrients from the soil, because when the crop residue is getting burned, the soil in that area, it also get damaged, and the nutrient or the fertility of the soil reaches to its minimum level. Now it's time for the prelims MCQ, and you people need to tell me the answer in the comment section. The right to environment comes under which of the following articles? Article 19, Article 20, Article 21 or Article 22? So give me the answer in the comment section, and that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Till we meet next time, keep reading, keep writing, and keep subscribing to the channel.
For more informative content, like, share, and subscribe, and do not forget to press the bell icon to get the notifications.